I'll be just dealing in another 45 to 50 minutes on avascular necrosis of the head of the femur, the diagnosis and the management. Osteonecrosis of the head of the femur. This presentation. This presentation will cover the history, the definition, etiological factors, proposed pathogenesis, clinical presentation, evaluation, classification, and staging, and natural history, and finally, the management. It was Koenig who noted this condition way back nearly about 240 years ago and named it as osteochondritis dissecans. Vascular occlusion as a cause of bone marrow necrosis was thought to be the primary cause of osteonecrosis, and that's why the term avascular necrosis became popular later. It was Hinisch who later, with numerous causes, enumerated the numerous causes of traumatic osteonecrosis, and he described the attention of traumatic cause as osteonecrosis and also the idiopathic cause of osteonecrosis of the head of the femur. Osteonecrosis of the hip, as I told you though, in a publication, it was first published in 1738 by Monroe as an incapacitating disease, primarily affecting the active population, usually in the third or in the fifth decade and to the fifth decade of life. And the causes have been found to be varied, and the pathogenesis even today is not very well understood, and with a male-female ratio of 4:1. Osteonecrosis is the death of living elements involving the bone, that is the cells, including the marrow. With progressive destruction and alteration of bone architecture as a result of compromised vascularity. As you would appreciate here, the radiological picture and the histological picture, as you see, with a progressive destruction and alteration of bone architecture as such, and that is the classical avascular necrosis. What are the causes, etiopathogenesis, and the different mechanisms of osteonecrosis? Usually due to vascular disruption. Say the classical example is a femoral head fracture. As you see in the particular X-ray, you see a fractured neck of the femur which was operated with the two screws, and you would appreciate nearly after 1.5 years, the patient has developed an avascular necrosis of the head of the femur. The vascular compression or constriction is the second cause, which results in an increased intraosseous pressure in the bone. Thereby, it results in impairment of blood supply to a particular part of the bone, especially the head of the femur. The third cause is intravascular occlusion by thrombosis of the main vessel, which supplies the head and neck of the femur. It can be due to hypofibrinolysis, which has been found to be a cause. It can be due to an embolization of the vessel. It can be due to direct cellular toxicity, as in irradiated here, the irradiation which is undertaken around the hip for various causes of cancer, which can directly bear a cellular toxicity results and results in AVN. Or it can be due to altered differentiation of mesenchymal stem cells, like alcohol, overdose of alcohol, and steroids, which is very well known today. The other causes are intravascular occlusion like thrombophilia, low protein CNS, activated protein, or it can be due to C resistance and factor V mutation, which can cause any vascular necrosis of the head of the femur also. It can be due to hypofibrinolysis, like high PAI activity, PA1 polymorphisms, and high lipoprotein, that is A. That is embolization, either due to fat and air, and even due to sickle cell conclusion. So these are, in short, the different causes of avascular necrosis of the head of the femur. Coming to the direct cellular toxicity,